What's up, guys? I'm BTC. The PTR just got updated, and there are some massive nerfs and buffs. I was not kidding when I said that these changes are going to be massive. In fact, this first one is one of the biggest changes that the game has ever had. So, the first one is a general thing, and damage reduction from armor reduced from minus 5 to minus 3. Developer comments, before this change, armor reduced all incoming damage by up to 5, maxing at half of the normal amount. This change reduces the damage reduction to 3 while still capping at half. This change will be mostly noticeable on heroes that fire quickly or in bursts of shots, such as shotguns, and which do more than 6 damage per shot. For example, Soldier 76's heavy pulse rifle will now do 16 damage per shot to armor, up from 14, an increase of 15%. Armor was a bit too strong overall, especially when being healed quickly and often. This change will help more heroes fight against higher armored enemies. That is a massive change. Now, it's going to have a big impact against the individual characters, like Reinhardt will die faster, D.Va will get demeched a lot faster, especially because they're nerfing her a little bit more. I'll get to that in a minute here. But it means that the individual tanks are still going to get destroyed faster. But is this going to have any major impact on the meta? It might not. It might kind of shift things to a more DPS-heavy meta. But realize that Goat's comp is still going to be very tanky, very durable, and still going to have all of that AoE healing. So yeah, the couple of tanks, the Reinhardt and the D.Va, have less damage reduction from armor, but the tanks on the other team also have that lower damage reduction. So they're going to be able to just roll right over you just like they were before. So I don't know if this is actually going to hurt Goats again. So this is one of those weird things where it's like, oh, you're reducing the effectiveness of the tanks so that the Goats comp won't work, but the other team is losing their effectiveness too. So when everyone gets dropped down, it doesn't, you know, like it all kind of balances out. But we'll go into the next thing, which is also armor related, and that is for Brigitte. She got yet another nerf. Rally now has a maximum duration of 30 seconds. Developer comments, sometimes Rally could cause a snowballing effect where it was too difficult to deal with increased health of Brigitte's allies before she built up another one. This change puts a cap on how long her Rally effect can last to make it a bit more manageable in those situations. Alright, so this is the problem that I have with Blizzard trying to balance this. They make changes, and then they go ahead and they make other changes that make the original ones redundant or unnecessary, and then they don't go back and they fix it. So what am I talking about here? Well, they made it so that Brigitte's Rally can only cap at 100 bonus armor. And they did that because you could have permanent bonus armor. So they reduced it. But now that you can't have permanent bonus armor anymore, they should lift that or increase it back up to 150 or to 200 or whatever it is. Because it's only temporary now, you don't need that lowered amount. And this sort of balancing where they just seem to forget some of the changes that they did in the past just drives me nuts. It's kind of the same thing that they did with the Shield Bash. They kept increasing the cooldown of it again and again and again and again, and then they finally nerfed it into the ground for damage and not being able to go to the barriers, but then they never reduced the cooldown of it. So, like, all those extra nerfs that they had that they don't need anymore, and they don't go back and they change it. And I don't know why they do that. It's like they just completely forget. Anyways, moving on. Next one is D.Va. She also got a fairly significant nerf. This is Defense Matrix. Cooldown increased from 1 second to 2 seconds. Developer comments, this change allows D.Va's enemies to try to play around her Defense Matrix by increasing its downtime between uses. I think this is kind of okay, but again, if they're going to do this, then they probably should increase the total amount. This is another one of those where they kept reducing and reducing, and then they go and make another change that makes the previous one unnecessary, and they don't go back and fix it. But so this is going to make D.Va a little bit more vulnerable, and now she has to be more careful. And in case you don't know, the cooldown is when you activate the Defense Matrix, when you let go of that button, the cooldown is how long till you can use it again. Even if you have plenty of that fuel gauge, Even if it's like halfway full, you still have to wait until that cooldown is done. So just in case you were confused on how that worked. So this is definitely going to hurt D.Va just a little bit, but she's still an incredibly powerful character and is still probably going to be picked in almost every single comp. And the last one is a buff, but it is a pretty big one. It is for Reaper, the Reaping, which is his passive. Lifesteal was increased yet again from 30% to 50% of damage dealt. Developer comments, Reaper's passive is one of the main tools he has, which allows him to play aggressively when near his enemies. This change allows him to keep the pressure up as long as he can stay near his enemies enough to keep dealing damage. This change is particularly effective versus tanks, as they tend to do less damage than damage heroes. That's not actually true, because the tanks are capable of putting out just as much damage as all the DPS. And that's actually one of the bigger problems in the game. But anyways, and also take more damage from his Hellfire shotguns due to the larger hit volumes. So this is a pretty significant buff to Reaper in unorganized play on the lower bracket. In the upper bracket, Reaper is still probably going to be useless. He's still not going to be all that effective. In the lower bracket, I think you're going to see way more Reaper players, and I think they're going to be wrecking house with this new change. But for the upper bracket and for the pro scene, no, he's still not going to be used. Also, the Shadow Step is still the single worst ability in the entire game, and they need to replace it. My video has like something like 700,000 views and like 18,000 likes or something like that. And I don't know if Blizzard's even seen it at this point. This is a huge change for unorganized Reaper play, like I said, but it's not going to do anything to kind of like change the meta or anything like that. But that is definitely a big buff for that particular bracket. Those are all the changes that are on the PTR right now. If they add anything else, I'll be sure to let you guys know. What do you think about all of these changes? Let me know down below. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to see more, subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. Also, come hang out in my Discord server and my Twitch live stream. Special thanks to my Patreon supporters. If you'd like to see what kind of cool VIP rewards you can get, check the links down below. And remember, always, always blame the controller, because it's never your fault.